Hi, I'm Susanna, and I'm a product owner here at Pesler. Today I'm going to show you how to configure PRTG in order to use our Microsoft Azure Virtual Machine sensor. In order to set up the PRTG to work with the Microsoft Azure Virtual Machine sensor, you need to first create a device. So we create a device, we give our device a name. In this case, I will name it Azure Virtual Machine. You can leave the rest of the settings as they are, and then set DNS name as localhost. And then the next thing you need to do is scroll down until you find the credential group for credentials for Microsoft Azure. So once you enable this, you see you need four pieces of information in order to configure PRTG to work with the Azure sensors. This information you can find in the Azure portal. So let's have a look. I'm now in the Azure portal, and the first thing we need to do is create a new app registration. So I go into App Registrations and click on New Registration. There I need to give my registration a name. So in this case, I will call it PRTG Azure Sensors. The rest of the settings can stay as they are. And lastly, you're asked to give a redirect URI. If you have one available, you can use your own. Otherwise, you can use the one we suggest, which is login.windows.net. Once you fill out the information, all you need to do is click on Register. And now you've successfully created a new app registration. And on the overview page, you can see we have the application, our client ID, and the directory, our tenant ID. Those are both things we need for our PRTG, so I will just copy them right away. The next thing we need is a client secret. So again, we go into the Azure portal, and now we navigate to certificates and secrets. There, we click on New Client Secret, and we give our client secret a name. In this case, we can name it PRTG Azure Sensors Secret. And then you set the expiry date to whatever you like. I will leave it to the default of 6 months. So I click on Add, and here we see we have created a new client secret. You can now see the value or the token of this client secret, and you need to copy it immediately, because once you leave the page in the Azure portal, then you won't be able to see it ever again. So you either need to copy it immediately into PRTG, which is what I will do, or you can copy it in some local file and copy it into PRTG later. I will copy it now. And the last thing we need is a subscription ID. So we go again into the Azure portal and now navigate to Home. And there we need to go into our subscriptions. So you need to choose the subscription to which the virtual machine belongs that you want to monitor. And then you go to Access Control. There, the first thing you need to do is create a new custom role. So I click on Add and Add Custom Role. So as you can see here, you need to fill out some information, and there's two ways to do it. Either you do it manually, or you can do it in another, more simple way. So if you go to our online knowledge base article called How Do I Obtain Credentials and Create Custom Roles for Microsoft Azure Sensors, and scroll to the bottom, there you see a JSON structure. And if you take the content of this JSON structure and put it into a file in your local directory and then upload it in PRTG, the information will be uploaded automatically, or will be filled in automatically. So I have already done that. So all I need to do is go back, click on Start from JSON, and upload my JSON structure. Okay. So as you can see, the information has been filled in automatically. There's only one action missing, and you can see that from this red dot. So I go to assignable scopes, add assignable scopes, and I will assign my subscription to this custom role. So I click on add, and the last thing you need to do is review and create. You then need to check that the information is correct, and then click on create. All right, so we have successfully created the new custom role. The last thing we need to do is assign this role to the app registration we created a few minutes ago. And to do that, we go to add and add role assignment. For role, you select the role you have just created. So I select the role, and the assign access to can stay the same, and under select, you select the app registration you have created a few minutes ago. So in our case, PRTG, Azure Sensors. And then you click on save. Okay, and that's the configuration you need in a Microsoft Azure portal. So you now need to go to overview, get the subscription ID, and copy it into PRTG. Now we have all the information we need, so we click on OK. And the last thing you need to do is add the sensor. So we need to find the sensor. And there you can see all your virtual machine instances in your Azure account. And we will select them all and create. For each instant that you create, a sensor is created. And there you go. You now can see information regarding your virtual machine. So in this case, you can see information regarding the average CPU usage or the CPU credits consumed and remaining, and of course the status of your virtual machine. And you can see if based on the status you're build or not build accordingly. And that's all you need to know in order to use our Microsoft Azure Virtual Machine Sensor. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If so, please like and subscribe. If you have any new topics or new things you would like us to do a tutorial about, please feel free to put it in the comments. If you need help with PRTG, you can contact our support at our website. Have a nice day, and thanks for watching.